Welcome back to Let's Play Amberstar Blind on the Amiga. I am the RPG chick, Amethyst Lunatari. Going back to Crystal. I don't get on this damn thing. It's getting to be dark out. Looking at a map on my other monitor here. Continue following this road until it disappears. Well, we don't want to go through that. Alright, now if I click wait, you can see the time pass. Very helpful. I'm just going to hold the mouse down. So we have newly, as of last episode, a new member, Spike. Silk is now a full-fledged level 1 thief. And we can see again. Great stuff. Looking for water. I should zoom out a little bit. Okay, this is water, but... I think so. I think we're on the wrong side of all this crap, though. I don't know. Actually, we're okay. The solid oak doors of the City of Crystal tower above you. Oh, goody. Oh, that's right. We have to get off the horse. Still towering above us. Got it. Okay. Now, hold on a second. Switching to my other map here. I'm prepared this time, so bore the hell out of you guys. So we came in the south gate, so we need to go... We're looking for another animal to talk to. This should be the Jewel Tavern. For a cat. We could previously not talk to them. So I thought we saw another cat. I'm not sure. I mean, if not, we have business in this town elsewhere because we want to enlist. Gryban has a paladin. Lots of ouchies. I went out the other way. Maybe there wasn't a cat. I'm going to look a little bit more for one. Because it would be silly to come in here looking for a cat half-assed. God, these things are in the way, we can't step over them. Guest house reception. Yeah, because we... I didn't mean to hit that. No! Stopped it. Straight this way, thank you. Maybe I remembered wrong. You and the cat would be out near the beginning. Definitely not out there. This is where the gnome is. Pretty sure there's no cat out there. Thank you. what's this way? That's reception. Alright. No cat. How do I get out of here again? Ah! Alright. Now the interesting thing is I just realized this guy up in the northwest section of town, he wants a bone. And we got a bone from the dog, so I am going to go deal with him. Now, I don't know if I should leave all this stuff in, if you guys want to see where I go. This is annoying. We're back to the beginning. I come to really like this song. The wrong way, I believe. We want to be like up. Way up. Like up. I think he's in here. Yeah, it's annoying. What can you do? Am I headed the right way? I'm in the corner here. The other way. This way. Do I want to turn in here? Yes. I hope this is the bone the guy wants, because, well, he's really annoying hiding in the middle of nowhere like this. Oh. Oh, I'm on Spike! Yeah, because he doesn't understand animal. Makes sense. So it's a bone. My bone of wisdom. I must tell you that I can read the future from bones when I throw them on the ground. But unfortunately, I have lost my most important bone. Some time ago, I was called to Twin Lake by the Lord Chancellor Carwain to help him with a problem with his sewers, but unfortunately he did not want to believe me that the rats are the evil in the sewers. When I left Twin Lake, I must have lost one of my bones. I think I asked Carwain about the bones and he didn't know anything. So who actually has the bone? I think I gave it to Trazrek. Firlas. Okay. Which item would you like to give? Bone. Many thanks. As a reward, I will look into the future for you. Firlas places the bone on the floor so that it points... We need, like, quotes around what he says. Places the bone on the floor so that it points to the others and then grips the bone with both hands. He moves his hands a few times to the left and right, and then throws the bone high up into the air. It clatters loudly on the dusty floor. He stares at the bone, and you can see that his pupils turn milky white. After a few seconds of meditation, he begins to speak a few words in a strange language. I'm going to translate this. I have to translate this with the special code. It's a pain in the butt. So hopefully I will remember to write somewhere over here what this says. I can now see part of your future before me. Join what is apart. You must find the 13 parts of the Amberstar. When you have them, hurry to the clearing where the many rivers wind. The altar is in the Forest of Unity, which will join again what was apart. Okay, so when I have all the parts to the Amberstar, go to a clearing where there's a lot of rivers. The altar is in the Forest of Unity, so that puts the parts of the Amberstar back together. Got it. And then there's something else for me to translate. Firlas sits down on the wooden crate, trembling slightly. I hope my vision means something to you. I believe I can give you something else which will be useful to you. Firlas searches briefly in a leather bag hanging around his neck and then gives you a piece of the Amberstar. We got a first piece of the Amberstar, guys? I think this is one of the 13 parts you are seeking. I found this piece in a nearby river many years ago. May it help you to complete your mission. Awesome! Piece of Amberstar. Nice. Transfer which item? There you go. Thank you very much. Now we can say nothing about the bone. Do you have anything else to say? I'm sorry, but I cannot help you at the moment. I am too exhausted to see into the future. I didn't say about that. I just want to, like, shoot the breeze with you, guy. Alright. Know any secrets? Alright. Say anything about the Amber Star. Alright. That's awesome. Can't believe we found the Amber Star, baby. So there it is. Piece of Amber Star. Just like that. I had no idea that would happen. $500 grams. I wonder if we ever get, like, kind of flavor text or something like that with looking at these items? I guess not. Because you figure if there was anything interesting written, it would be on a piece of the Amber Star, right? Alright. Which parchment is this again? For. Kind of want her to have at least yeah, he's got space. Okay. That was awesome. Thank you again. Okay, now if I remember, I'm gonna cut out all of this looking for the Guild of Paladines. Because it's annoying. It's all the way over here, which you have to come up through here, and there's literally nothing else in this whole freaking place except for that. Guild of Paladines. Didn't mean to do that. So So we are here. This is us. Yeah, we're not this dude. Alright, this is just someone we talk to. Alright, it's over here, isn't it? A 1,000 gold. Sheesh. Do I hit this? Yeah. Which skill should be trained? Nice. RMS is. This is use magic. Do we want that for a paladine? Hold on, guys. I gotta consult my manual. I was going back into this window and I hit something by mistake. I think I increased parry. I don't know if I can decrease it again. I'll leave it. The thing for paladines is attack and parry and use magic, read magic scrolls. For now, I'm just gonna put it. Attack, parry, and new magic scrolls. Gryban has reached level 1. The maximum LP is life points is now 23. Spell points is now 5. The spell learning points is now 9. I can give him another level for 600 gold. Oh, level up! Now we got level up instead of join guild. Which skills should we drain? I only got 10 for paladin. That's sad. Gryban level 2. Life points now 42. Whoa. He's gonna be our tank, definitely. Yeah, 42 life points. Hell to the ass. Maximum LP is now 10. SP, spell points is now 10. Spell learning points is 18. He needs 99 experience for the next level. Sweet. No. No, I do not. I want to take the gold. Thank you. Nice! Alright. We're done with him. How do I get out of here again? Isn't it to the side? Oh, I barely see that doorway. Okay. Now it's late, or early, depending on how you look at it. We need to heal. We've sold stuff. Oh, we need to give him stuff now. Now, yeah, it does not give them points, so they have a new maximum, but he's still stuck at 4, which is old maximum, so we have to rest to just get back up to maximum every time they level. This is like one of couple techniques. that I've seen in games, a lot of times they'll gain as many points as their total. Like, not up to full, but say they gain 20 points, they'll get 20 points back. You know what I'm saying? So if they're already damaged from before, they're still damaged by the same amount of points. It's just their maximum is now increased, so they're still down, like they're still hurt by 3 points or something like that if they already were. Only now it would be 39 instead of 42. Yeah. I don't know if I'm explaining it right. I'm very tired. But, and the other way is to have, okay, you've leveled up, and here's your new max, and you're at your max. That's my favorite way to do it, but this game doesn't have it that way. So he just has clothes, but one of us has chainmail. I'm not trying to use the item. I'm trying to give it. I'm trying to give it to Gryban. With the buckler. And the short sword. Nice. Let's see how he goes up. Alright, he's just gone up from 5 to 12. And he's got this knife, so his attack. Well, let's look at his defense. Can we see defense on this? Yeah, defense, of course. Buckler. 14. And his attack is going to go from 5 to 10. Our kick-ass paladin over here. Nice. Or paladine. I like it. He's got leather boots. Do you have anything else, like, to give him? I'm the impression we might have had some special kind of boots. I'm not sure, though. Here's another pair of leather boots. So we know now that he's well, we need to heal his stun. We need to take his stun away, so where do we do that? Let's see. There's a food store, Temple of Bela, healer, which is at 6, which is all the way out of this paladin section, so I'm gonna like fast forward crap. Sell a few things here. Just curious to see if he'd want a piece of the Amberstar. Imagine selling that by mistake. Need a mace. I'm gonna sell this mace. Hold on. I'm gonna hold on to the war axe. Sell these regular clothes. We have one more party member that we maybe can enlist, so I'm gonna see if they need leather or leather boots. I'll sell the knife. They do tend to come with their own paltry weapons. That's it. Thank you very much. We need to pass through, I think. No. Can I pass through? I wonder what the deal is with that lock. Ugh. Why? I must have clicked too many times. I guess not this way. Tucked away in the middle of nowhere. Alright. So it's like I can click this. You do not have enough gold to pay for my services. What? Oh wait, I didn't put the gold in. I was about to give up too. 65 gold. Gryban has been healed! Alright. Nice. Do we have a food store here? Because I think when you... I'm not sure. I'm trying to remember if it's when you travel or when you rest outside, you need food. So we're going to be resting outside for a while. Because I want to get us all up to full. Like, completamente full. Food. Food. Food store. You are a food store. I get it. You're a food store. It's... annoyingly out of the way, like everything here. I think I'm going the wrong way. Thank you. Get the food, man! What if everyone has 10 rations? Can we afford that? I mean, we'll use them eventually. Everyone has either 3 or 4 rations, I believe. Even Spike needs to eat. Oh, we didn't take the... Thank you. We didn't actually take the food. Alright, so let's check. Well, she's actually got 15 rations now. 13? 12? 9? 3? Oh. I forgot to switch to Spike at one point. Poor Spike. There you go. So I've got 10, 13, for some reason, 12, 9, 8. Yeah, I don't know how that turned out. Good. We have distributed the rations of doom. The rations of stopping us from dying of starvation. Actually, not too far from the exit. We are done in Crystal once again. Okay, I'm just gonna save in case I made a horrible mistake for some reason. So we want to make camp. So I have to do this every time? Now, from what I understand, there's no time limit here. Yeah, this is gonna heal to full, guys. And, yeah, then we'll be heading on to... check the map again. I want to see if I can go to Gemstone, which might be difficult to get around. But I think we might be able to do it. Because it's very far away from Crystal. So it's another city, Gemstone. So, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always, seek adventure.